One very elegant way to treat SMA is to try and alter that process of alternative splicing of exon 7 of these RNAs that arise from SMN2. And in fact, in that way, you would convert all of that truncated form of the RNA that's useless, and it makes a useless protein. If you could convert all of that to a full-length transcript and make all of that full-length transcript make normal SMN protein, you could imagine that would be a very powerful way to basically restore the SMN2 gene to the function of what an SMN1 gene would do. And so that's been another major push in the field to try and identify ways to alter this balance of including exon 7, and that is to use small pieces of oligonucleotides that are in fact a drug, but not in the traditional way that we think of aspirin or other types of drugs that we generally take. This is a type of molecule that specifically will recognize SMN2 pre-RNAs and alter this process of splicing and encourage the inclusion of exon 7 into those molecules and make a full-length protein. So that strategy is another major way in which people have been trying to alter splicing of SMN2-derived transcripts.